Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Nice to see you again. Today's video is not the one I thought I was going to be filming. In fact, here's the intro I've just shot. Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel again. Nice to see you. Today's video is going to be a little bit of a mishmash of a few things. We're hopefully going to get some fish into Mega Tank, which is in there. So this is some of the driftwood that I've repurposed from storage bins and other tanks that I've collected over the years. This is the kind of the layout that I'm thinking for Mega Tank. But all I've done with these ones is I've taken a few pieces together and kind of put screws through to hold them together and then siliconed up the holes. I don't know whether it's one of those things that sounded like a good idea in my head, but when I tried it, we'll see. But we'll get them in. Maybe put some rocks in as well and see what it looks like. And here is the reason we can't film that video. So come into the fish room to shoot the next part of that video and we've got another bloody leak. Mega tank, mega pain in the ass. Other noises. So, for those of you who don't know, this is my DIY project, which is not going very well. It's an 8 foot by 4 foot by 3 foot tank. And I was just getting to the point where I wanted to shoot a video about me moving some fish into it. But we've sprung a leak somewhere. It seems to be concentrated in this corner, which is the same corner we had problems with last time. But yeah, this is basically damp to the touch. So water is coming through somehow. I mean, it's not a lot of water because the water level hasn't actually dropped much, but it's enough to make it damp on the floor. It's not gushing out or anything. It's more coming out here. I mean, this isn't actually as damp, but I don't know if it's just running along there and coming over there. But yeah, very much seems to be that corner that's the problem. So if you don't know, I've made this tank using the slightly alternative method of using liquid rubber. So no fiberglass, no pond shield, pond armour, just liquid rubber and geotex. And I can already feel all the people going, ha ha ha, I told you so. Fair enough, you got me. I suppose I have to concede when I'm beaten. I don't know that I'm beaten quite yet, but yeah, this is doing my head in now. I was just about to start putting fish in here, so I had kind of an idea to make a video about me adding Humphrey, my flower horn, into this tank and giving him a few months of just roaming free and stretching his fins, so to speak. But yeah, that's not going to happen. And the reason I was thinking about putting Humphrey in this tank is these are my Oscars. So I've got three of these Colombian wild type Oscars, which are obviously very small still. I reckon there's a good 3 to 6 months of growing left in them before I can put them in the big tank and they don't look ridiculous. So I was thinking about putting these guys in with the arowana and let them grow out a bit and let Humphrey stretch his legs in the big tank. So I was going to make a video about mixing fish that you're just not sure about. Over here we've got the gold Somme. It's actually sold to me as a green terror, but I think with a little bit of research it's definitely not. Very pretty fish nevertheless. But all these fish are eventually going to live together and they're all going to grow quite a lot. So I thought it might be worth experimenting while they're still small, because there's a school of thought that says if you get fish when they're still small, even if they're very aggressive types, and they grow up together, you can achieve some good results. So this is Pearl, my Giardini arowana. She's currently, I don't know if it's a she or a he, currently in quite a large tank on her own to grow out. So I was thinking about using this tank as a bit of an experiment to see how well they fare together. So in my experience, there's generally three ways it can go when you're introducing fish that you don't really, you're not 100% sure of the compatibility. One, they can take an instant dislike to anything in the tank. So that's the kind of thing Humphrey would do. Put any fish in his tank and he will just instantly try and kill it. It doesn't even need to be a fish. Put anything in his tank and he will instantly try and kill it. Maybe there's things you can do with that about adding more like sight breaks and things like that, a bigger tank. So maybe in Mega Tank he might put up with or he might tolerate other fish in there. I don't think he would, but it's the kind of instant aggression of, nope, not having it. Get out my tank. I just want you gone. The second one is the kind of, it's not necessarily an aggression, it's just that I'm going to eat whatever I can find. And this is your bichers and things like that, where they're not wholly aggressive, they're more Some people call them ambush predators. I call them more idiot predators because they just kind of bumble along. And if something hits them in the face, they try and bite it and see if it's edible. Certainly the bachelors I've kept in the past, that's the way they've all kind of acted. So they're not necessarily an aggression, but that might be something that will show itself rather than the first couple of days with a really aggressive fish. That'll show itself in the first few weeks and couple of months. And then there's the third category of just the complete psychopaths. And that's the things like the angelfish is a really classic example of this, where they'll be fine for months, if not years, and then one day they'll just decide, you know what, I think I might kill everything in the tank today. And they just go rogue and attack everything. So the approach that I'm going to take with these guys is basically put them in the same tank together. I'm going to move things around to just kind of shake it up a little bit for the arowana, so he's not thinking he's tank boss necessarily. Put in lots of places for them to hide, but monitor it really closely for the first few days. Because I think if I get over that initial get out my tank, I want to kill you and eat you, I don't think these are the type of idiot predators that will go and just accidentally eat each other. I don't think they're necessarily the rogue predators. If there's going to be a problem, it should happen fairly quickly. But again, this is the experiment to try it when they're still young, they're still growing, to see whether or not they tolerate each other. But plenty of line of sight breaks, plenty of hides, caves, rocks, things to get in and hide behind if they want a little bit of respite. And we'll see how they get on, basically. As for this bloody thing, all I can think of right now is getting a sledgehammer. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to empty it, let it dry out, leave it for a while, reassess. I know in my head there are things we can do. We can take the glass out, we can reseal it, we can put pond liner in, there are other options to fix this, but I just can't be doing with it, if I'm completely honest. I just want to pour petrol on it and set it on fire. Ever have that feeling where you just wish you'd never started something in the first place? Ah well. I'm going to make a plea to say that almost half the people watching these videos aren't subscribed, so please subscribe to make sure you catch up on the latest content. But really, it's just going to be a large man banging his head against a brick wall and screwing up everything he touches. If you can subscribe, go and watch a couple of videos, it really helps out. Energy prices are going through the roof here, they're due to go through the roof even more in the next few months. So running a tropical fish room has become a bit of a silly hobby to have. So anything that I make through YouTube is just going to keep this place running. So click that subscribe button and go and watch a couple of videos and click all the... It's a thing to click it, click it. Oh, one of my angels has started laying. This one's been cleaning that bit of glass for a while. I'm glad someone does. And as I started talking there, it looked like she was starting to lay some eggs. Obviously now that I've pointed a camera at her, she's going to cease and desist. I don't know if you can see the little egg tube there. There you go. There you go. She's like, back off, buddy. Not ready yet. I'll just eat all them. Brilliant. But for any of you first-time angel or discus keepers, this is very often what happens. The female, when she's first at it, I'll just go up and down laying eggs and then eating them. So what I really should do is I should figure out which pairing this is, if it is even a pairing. Get them off into a separate tank that's nice and clean. See if I can't get them breeding. So this isn't going to come to anything, but cool to watch, nevertheless. Okay, we've learned something new. As well as being unable to build fish tanks, we can add remembering to press the record button to the list of things that I can't actually do. So we added the Oscars. You didn't see any of it. Well, I added a couple of the Oscars to the tank with the Giardini arowana in it. And I thought they were big enough. They look far too big to fit in his mouth. But he just basically spent the first 10 minutes aggressively chasing them down, trying to kill them. So quickly got them back out again so we can put the Giardini arowana in the Humphrey camp of I will kill anything you put in my tank. So I need a new approach. My new approach was going to be create a divider. So using something like this, this is like egg crate or lighting diffuser, depending on what you call it. You can put this into the same tank and then the fish can at least live in the same tank and potentially get used to each other. I don't know whether it'll actually work, and I don't actually have enough because this is my last remaining bit and it's not big enough to create a divider, so what is the point of this video now? So I don't really know where that leaves us. I've emptied Mega Tank again. I'm going to wait for it to completely dry out, get all the sand out, strip it back completely, set fire to it. 10,000 likes and I smash it with a sledgehammer. I'll put the Oscars back in their tank, so they're feeling a bit sorry for themselves, but they're fine. They were only literally minutes that they were in there, getting a bit bullied. Discus are still nice. Yeah, everything else in the fish room is kind of fine, everything's going alright, but yeah, I'm just a bit put off with the Mega Tank disaster that it is. I don't know what to say really. Sometimes that's just life. With a fish room with lots of fish tanks, things don't always go well. Sometimes challenges are there, they need to be overcome, they need to find solutions for things, and that's, as much as I'm mourning about it now, that's one of the things I usually quite enjoy, is finding solutions to all these little problems that are presented. But the Mega Tank one is particularly annoying me at the moment. But the Arowana tank, yeah, there's things we can do. I just need to get a few more bits and bobs so we can look at that. The rest of the tanks, all the fish are doing well. The discus are doing really good. The angels have started breeding. The pea puffers are looking great. The snakeheads are out and about again. Other things are going well. Humphrey's happy. And I think I've identified what my mystery fry were.
Well, I'm not sure how well you can see that because I haven't got the macro lens on my camera, but the bigger ones got a bit of a neon blue tinge to them, so that makes me think they might be the dwarf neon rainbows, the panchaks. Panchaks? I can't even think anymore. But there's a whole boatload of them in there. There must be a dozen or so. So that's good. The Congo tank, that's doing really well, unless you're a plant. Still do love these fish. Congo tetras are amazing, as are the Alestes. But I'm thinking about renaming them mini piranhas. Look at them go for that food. But yeah, all the fish are doing well in this tank. I'm loving the way the tannins are being retained. So even though it is more of a hardscape than an aquascape, I don't mind that. Colours under this light with the darker water. Fantastic, some of them. The fins on some of these Congo tetras and the colours. It's great stuff. So one thing about super aggressive fish is they're usually super aggressive feeders as well. Look at all the algae in there, that needs to get sorted out. So, let's see if you'll take a wee worm. Of course not, you're just going to ignore it this time, aren't you? Brilliant.
Yes, challenging week in the fish room this week, but thank you very much for joining me. I hope you won't have enjoyed that, because that's what is this video even? It's a nonsense. Thanks for staying with me till the end anyway. Let me know if you stayed to the end in the comments. Right, see you next time, bye!